Please be seated. Travelers, be at peace. You are welcome here. Our doors open, hands extended across the table. Bread is broken in shared contentment. Hearts are warmed and healed anew. Let this house be a harbor in breeze or gale. Travelers, fair winds be at your sail. The poem I've just shared is one that's been spoken over many meals just south of here at the Fuller's Cabin in Zephyr Cove, a place that holds decades of memories full of love and laughter, a place very special to many of us here, but for Bryant and Kayla, it is more special. It became a safe harbor, a place where their love grew, and through a simple question Bryant asked Kayla, it became home. The poem represents the shared values between Bryant and Kayla, two warm, welcoming hearts, open doors, a passion for bringing people together, around a table, or just around a bottle of wine. Through so many memories and moments, we've all been witness to their love, and the love they all share with us. So it's only fitting that we spend this beautiful afternoon in a place that means most to them, surrounded by the people that they've brought together for years. I would personally like to thank all of you for being here today. Thank you for being a special part of our lives. Special thank you to the parents, DJ and Teresa, John and Lisa, and all those who have traveled near and far to be with us today. Bryant, Kayla, this day will fly. It's full of emotion. Many people here remember how fitting their wedding day was, so I want you to take a few moments and just look into each other's eyes. Think about the happiness you're feeling. You're right where you're supposed to be. In this place, in this moment. Let that feeling register. Now look out at everyone and remember that they are here to support your dreams, your goals for your marriage, and the next chapter of your story. I feel so lucky to be standing here today in front of two people I've considered family for longer than we've been, and of course, all of you. I'm grateful to have known both Bryant and Kayla for so many years, and witnessing their love for so long has been one of my greatest joys. I believe I've had the chance to meet most of you, but for those that I have not met, my name is Devin, and although I stand here as officiant, I have a few more roles in this story. Co-best man, best friend, brother-in-law times two, but my first role in the story was technically new hire, and I can tell you for sure that I would have never imagined taking a video call with two guys from Nike in my borrowed professor's office in college would lead me here, but I'm so grateful it did. It is true, like most romantic relationships in the 21st century, Bryant and I met online, but unlike most online relationships, our love is effortless. Ever since that moment I met Bryant, it felt like I'd unlocked a new world. My life grew in scale, it was more adventurous, more fulfilling, and yes, unfortunately, more hungover. But the truth is, from the moment I met Bryant, I felt my roots grow, being exposed to new friends, new experiences, and a side of the world that I've not seen. And the more I thought about it, the more I realized that that is truly what Bryant needed us for. Someone who brings people together and wants them to succeed and enjoy life to its fullest. Someone who is always striving for bigger, better, more grandiose, and you bet someone that will always join you for that final drink of the night. Bryant has always been my biggest supporter, confidant, and most importantly, my best friend. I just have to call Bryant, I think often, because I know he's the only one that can solve that work mystery or be the one that will talk something through with me. It's a relationship that I love and cherish every day. Now, I remember first hearing about Kayla, and in typical Bryant Bowler fashion, I remember him downplaying it for quite some time. And then, as we planned to visit Portland in December of 2016, his tune changed. It became an immense excitement around me getting a chance to meet Kayla. How interesting, I thought. This was different. Now, if you ask Kayla what I thought about her after we met, she'll say the same thing she's been saying for years. You want to fill this in? You hated me. While that is wildly untrue, I reflected on why that night remained so vivid in my memory. And it was because Kayla was different. She was so sweet and eager to meet me, one of those people that you knew instantly had a good heart. And because perhaps in that moment, a part of me knew that I'd be seeing a lot more of Kayla, and more importantly, she became a partner to my best friend. As most relationships go, there was always a moment where you reach with friends where, if there were to be a breakup, the friends would say, well, we're not going to stop being friends with them. And for us, I can honestly say that was very quick with Kayla. Because we knew that Kayla represented those same special qualities we value in lifelong friends and partners. She is a burst of energy and brightness, someone that always wants to bring people in, someone who shares love and exudes kindness, someone who will always give you the time of day, someone who, at her core, represents the sweetest things in life. And of course, you bet she's going to be the last one on that dance floor tonight. Because you know that's what you get with Kayla, a brightness, kindness, and an energy that you just want to be around. From early on in their relationship, Kayla and I became close. And to this day, it's a bond that I love and appreciate every day. Kayla and I actually used to joke and talk about how funny it would be if we actually ended up in the same family. And today, that becomes a reality, and it is so special. The truth is, I take so much pride in both Bryant and Kayla being my brother and sister, and it's a part of my life that I hold so dear to my heart. And being a part of the same family as Bryant and Kayla, I have truly been a passenger to the relationship. And I can say, in my heart of hearts, when I think about Bryant and Kayla and all the moments we share, I truly can't help but smile, because there is just this bright cloud that follows them, and it's something I know that each and every one of us has seen. Their dedication to family, their commitment to making sure each and every person is having the time of their lives at all times, their shared love for being inclusive and welcoming. From early on, it was so clear that the two of them represented a perfect balance for each other. And having been through it all, as well moments of happiness, love, laughter, dancing, as well as loss and compassion, I've truly felt the deep and meaningful love that they share for each other, the love they shared with me and everyone here today. You are both incredible individuals on your own, but together you really are better. You truly amplify the best of each other. And I speak for everyone here by saying we are so grateful to know the both of you and to be a part of your story. Bryant and Kayla have chosen to write me personal vows. Kayla.
There is something about you from the moment we first met. We had an undeniable connection and we completely stole my heart. You embody this energy that I just want to bottle. You have an infectious spirit, an optimism and creativity, an unmatched sense of adventure. Life is never boring with you. You're dedicated, hardworking, compassionate. You're the most caring and thoughtful man that you've ever known. I love our goofiness, our never-ending nicknames for one another. Our chef nights, doing long runs on the waterfront in Portland, going out to the gorge. I love spending time with you on the mountains, and our shared love for trying new wine. Thank you for constantly reminding me to be open-minded, take new adventures, and not take myself too seriously. Every day I feel so lucky that you chose me. As we embark on this next chapter of life, I'd like to make you a few comments. I promise to keep growing with you. I promise to always keep laughing and never lose our spark. I promise to respect you, to be patient, and to listen. Still working on that. I promise to make sure I'm not just hungry when I start to get upset. I promise to be your rock and stand behind you through the hard times and be your biggest supporter in the good ones. I promise to always give you smooches, even when I don't want to. Still working on that. I promise to always give you the benefit of the doubt. I promise to trust you wholeheartedly. And I promise to always put that first. I love Bryant, and I still love you.
What struck me about you, what first struck me about you was your spirit. The joy you bring to everyday life is infectious, and your brightness shines in everything around you. I never thought I'd find someone with as much energy as me, but from the moment I met you, I've been playing catch up ever since. What made me fall in love with you is your soul. Your kindness could fill this forest, and your care is as deep as your love. Your thoughtfulness and devotion to the people you love amazes me every day. What I love about you most is that you've truly made me a better person. You've reignited old passions that I had lost, and introduced me to new ones that we need to share together. You have grounded me, you have challenged me, you have guided me. You have made me a better friend, a better son, a better man, and that makes me a better man for you. I promise to love you with my whole, complete, and whole heart, no matter what life brings us. I promise to constantly find new ways to make you happy and to make sure that we never stop laughing together. I promise to calm your conscience when you're feeling anxious and give you a boost of confidence when you need it most. I promise to always be there to listen, even if I don't say anything with a single word. I promise to try and embrace the mornings with you, even if I can never match your energy. I promise to keep reminding you how smart, talented, and beautiful you are. I promise to always show you how appreciative I am for everything you do. I promise to try to be less slow, because I know you hate being rushed. I promise to tuck you in before bed, give you a kiss before I go, and tell you I love you every chance I get. I promise to be your even keel, no matter what happens along our journey, trust that I will be there to keep us steady. I promise to be your devoted partner in this life, to always be team us, to take the good with the bad, and to always remember that as long as we have each other, everything will be okay. Kayla, you have shown me a depth of love I never thought was possible, one that has grown each and every day. I can only imagine how our love will continue to grow in the future. But one thing I know for certain is the best is yet to come. So let's get started.
Traditions touch us, they connect us, and they expand us. 35 years ago, Kayla's parents, DJ and Teresa, lit a unity candle made by DJ as a symbol of their love and commitment to each other. Today, Bryant and Kayla will light the very same candle with the same intentions for their future. Bryant, Kayla, I'd like for you now to both declare that you take each other as spouses. Please respond by saying I do. Do you, Bryant, take Kayla as your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, respect her, and keep her, and to be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Do you take Kayla, do you take Bryant as your husband? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, and respect him, and keep him, and to be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And would you please pass the words? Kayla, please repeat after me. This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
I am yours today and forever. This ring is a token of my love.
This ring is a token of my love.
I am yours today and forever.
I am yours today.
Bryant, Kayla, remember to make your relationship work. It will take love. It will take trust. It will take dedication. And most of all, it will take commitment all to hold true to the journey we have both pledged to them. You have entered these woods as individuals, but you now leave here as one. By the power vested in me by the state of California, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Bryant, you may kiss the bride. Thank you. wedding tradition, we also got to do a first dance. So, we know what it is. Here we go, it's a little Matthew Korma. Songs, open dance floor. Please join the newlywed on the dance floor. Get warmed up. Everybody, please.
The sun hits like a bullet of faith, and then suddenly I'm wide awake. The fake bliss, all apologies made, was an enemy with no escape.
I'm gonna do a continuation of last night. I think I promised you guys 60 pages of PowerPoint, yes. But I'm actually back. I have content, and I have tissues. So we're going to have some fun. I want to say thanks to everybody who came out for the day to celebrate with Bryant and Kayla. Truly incredible from every corner of this country. Hats off to the Aussies, Jordan and Ellen. How many miles?
A lot.
How many hours? Thanks to Teresa, my lovely wife. 35 years. Kayla's mother. And I just want to say thanks to Kayla and Bryant and Teresa for the work that they put into making this all happen. Truly incredible. John and Lisa. Got visual on you now. Yep, there you are. For raising an incredible son. Thanks to the siblings. Max, where are you? Jen. Baby brother, baby sister, torturing their older siblings for years. So we're going to hear a little bit about that later. Thanks to Devin, our officiant. Also Jen's husband. Thanks to Liz and the crew here at Dancing Pines. Incredible. What a venue. What a day. Thanks to special call out to Max, Nevin, and Griffin. I'm a bit hyper. They took me out and ran me like a wild animal this morning for about an hour to get the energy like out. So I'm like good and relaxed. Calm me down. A few other special mentions. Noni, where are you? Bryant's grandmother, Noni, for everyone who needs to know, is our elder statesperson at this event. She's holding it down for all of us. We can only hope to be 97 and wandering around life of the party. Cheers to Noni. Quick mention for my father, Dave Jensen, who's not here. He unfortunately can't travel, so sends his wishes. And last but not least, for everybody that we've lost, not only from the pandemic, but in recent years, parents, grandparents, friends, they're up there looking down. Okay, I want to go back to the beginning. We're going to talk about the love story. How'd this thing get started? Kayla meets Bryant. September 2015, fast forward a year, and they're dating. Over the subsequent 5 years, they've navigated new jobs, multiple moves, I don't know how many music fests, I don't know how many weddings, a few trips to Europe, and lastly, a global pandemic. And they had a tough pandemic. They split the pandemic between the lake house here at South Lake Tahoe, the mountain house in Sun Valley, and the beach house, coastal California. It was possibly the shittiest pandemic that I've ever heard of. But I will say, the pandemic was a true test. And heading into sequestration, and locking yourself away, I said to Kayla and Bryant, I said, you guys are going to learn a lot. And you're going to either come out of this pretty stoked on each other, or it's going to be rugged. So as they say, this love is real. And here we are. Kayla, where do I begin? Promise not to cry. Your name says it all. Your name was chosen by your mother, and it actually means pure in Greek. Couldn't be a more perfect description. Your heart, your mind, your kindness, emblematic of purity from the time you were a little girl. It was always there. As I wrote this, I had all these flashbacks, memories of you as a little girl, running up the gravel road to catch the kindergarten bus, stacking huge piles of teddy bears in your little bedroom. But one that really stuck out, which was you and Max playing a game called Head of Entourage. And this is good content, folks. So, a couple words on this game, which, by the way, Kayla, you created. It had one rule. Max would do anything, literally anything. He was at Kayla's beck and call. He would make you snacks. He would bring you beverages. He would allow you to choose the movie for the evening or the takeout for the food for the evening if we were going out. He would allow you to choose the activity for the day. And moreover, he would never, ever complain because he was head of entourage. Where's Max? I can't see him. He's laughing. So, Bryant, buddy, fair warning, you are now head of Kayla's entourage. So, Kayla, you are the ultimate combination of the two of us. You've got my sort of head-down Midwestern work ethic, my focus, my desire to try to get along with everyone. That's the Minnesota in me. Steve and Julie, shout out to you, holding down the Minnesota side. You've got your mom's intelligence, her heart, her attention to detail, and her crazy, unwavering strength. You've grown to become this beautiful, caring, compassionate young woman, and you have this uncanny ability to bring positive energy to absolutely any situation. That's truly a gift. Okay, I got to do a few stories, right? Let's do some content. All right, I'm going to drone on. You guys will give me the hook here soon. So, Kayla, I want to talk a little bit about the first crush. You may not remember fourth grade or the puppy love or the exchange of cookies that went on for several weeks between this very nice young man and Kayla. And then it stopped. And Kayla came home one day and proclaimed to her mother that they were breaking up. The cookie exchange had ended, and of course for a fourth grader, this is total devastation. So Teresa, because she's very thoughtful on things like this, said, Kayla, you and I are gonna write some letters, we're gonna do a time capsule, and we're gonna describe, Brian's like, the person you would hope to marry in the future. And we're gonna put details down. We have the envelope. And it's dated March 15th, 2004, with a handwritten note from Kayla that says, "Do not open until the night before your wedding." So last night, we did just that. So let's have some fun here and see how well Teresa and Kayla predicted this evening and their future life. All right. So coming out of the blocks hot, Kayla opened this last night, no kidding. First page, Teresa called it. His name, John. And for most of you know, that is actually Brian's first name. I will say, Kayla, hold on. Kayla kind of had it a little different. She had Bobby. Where they met? Kayla, you said you met at Abercrombie, shopping for shirts. Okay, all right. I'm just going to say, Kayla, what was on your mind in fourth grade? And I'm also going to say that may be foreshadowing the Abercrombie event on the dance floor later tonight with, like, tarps down. All right. Couple more, and this is great. Occupation. The girls decided that he, the perfect he, would be a resident in medical school. I was like, awesome. Kayla's still supporting him. Well, the truth is, Bryant's a successful partner in a creative agency. And I looked at this and I said, Kayla, you got a dramatically better financial outcome than predicted. Here's to CM. Personality, last one, Kayla nailed it. She said, I want someone who's caring, generous and kind. Okay, let's talk about some fun here. Kayla, you've always had a love of mountain sports, water sports, lifelong passion for running. I need to give a shout out to David Abusamra, aka Abu. David was Kayla's friend, French teacher, cross-country coach, track coach for all 4 years of Kayla's high school, Governor's Academy in Byfield, Massachusetts. Go Govs. And I think most of you know Kayla's still a real competitor. She won't say it. She's like the dark horse, like, no, not competitive. So Kayla recently put down a half marathon PR at Hayward Field in Eugene, Oregon. And in fact, we keep track of this stuff in our family. It was actually the family PR. It stood for about 6 months. I'll let you guess who now holds it. But somehow we see that changing. Okay, I want to move on, talk about the love story. This will get a little bit mushy. Kayla, you graduated USD. You had the luxury of having the job offer like early senior year, so you were able to kind of blow off the entire year and just do whatever you wanted, right? You knew you were going to work for Nike. You had a signed offer. You were the only kid that I knew in our group of friends that had a white glove corporate move out of your ratty college apartment into Portland, Oregon. So you went, you know, straight from like, you know, college life to corporate life. So your mom and I had all these conversations when you moved to Portland. We're like, how's this gonna work out for Kayla's love life? And I said, Reese, let me explain. She's gonna get swept off her feet. It's only a matter of time. And here's how the story goes. He's probably a slightly older guy. Probably works like in the business. Maybe he might have worked at Nike. Probably an agency guy at this point. He's a guy who probably gets her, but has the same passion for travel and sports and great food and great wine and adventure. I guess it was destined. Kayla, your mom and I love you. Everyone in this room loves you. You found your soulmate. We look forward to the continuation of the love story you're writing with Bryant. Okay. BK. Is when we get to roast you up? All right. So here's the first report. Sorry, I'm going on here, but I'm giving you guys some backdrop. Kayla calls and says, I met this guy. Classic. I say, stop. Let me tell you what happened. He's a couple of years older. Probably works for an agency. Likes sports, music, food, travel, lives in Portland. Huh, shocker. So fast forward a few months, and we actually have the formal introduction. We figured we should probably meet at the mountain. This is like, not only is it baptism by fire, but it's good neutral territory, right? We're gonna take this guy and give him a little shakedown. And we're comfortable there, and we say, we'll bring Max, too, because Max can definitely open a can of whoop-ass on any guy that we don't like on the mountain. We're like, if shit goes sideways, Max can take care of this guy. So this was one of a lot of sports-related encounters with Bryant over the early years of the two of you dating. You know, the snowboarding, the kite surfing, the running, the hiking, the biking, the golfing, just a general obsession for staying active. So I learned about a year ago, Teresa and I learned this, that turns out that we've developed a bit of a reputation with Bryant and the friend group. And they say he affectionately refers to every visit as Jensen Boot Camp. I didn't know we could be a little hyperactive. Shocking. Okay, let's talk about food. Show of hands, you ever made a meal with Bryant? Who in the room has made a meal with Bryant? Okay, so you all know the story. You can't talk about Bryant without talking about food and beverage. And until we met you, we had no idea so much complexity and so much detail could go into the making of a sandwich.
Honestly, yes!
I mean, we're talking next level.
Yes!
That said, you've definitely brought skills to our family.
Absolutely.
You've taught us how to reheat day-old pizza in a frying pan. I mean, shit. Everybody needs that skill. You've taught us how to prep the coffee the night before. And actually how to grind coffee instead of just buying crappy coffee in a bag. Mm-hmm. You've taught us how to make breakfast sandwiches over hard. But most critically, you've taught us that you can actually drink more than just Chardonnay and IPAs. Incredible. Broadening the palate. So you're a foodie, Brent, but it's more than food. It's a love of the finer things in life, and it's attention to details that make the mundane truly spectacular. But it's your patience, and last but not least, it's the grace that you show in all these situations. You're always the last to sit down at the table. Here's to that. Okay, shifting gears, we're gonna talk about the proposal. This gets a little bit mushy. I guess it's 18 months ago now, which time flies, and we're hosting Bryant and Kayla for Christmas in Connecticut. And this is, you know, Teresa likes it to be kind of like a Hallmark movie situation. So it's New England in the winter, right? And we've got the kids and the festivities and pajamas and carriage rides and snow. And I think it rained in the middle of it and it snowed again. We had like the whole gamut for weather. And near the end of the weekend, Bryant shows up in the kitchen. Kayla's like taking a shower, and he shows up in the kitchen, and he knows we're down there, and he says, do you guys have a couple minutes? Literally 15 seconds into the conversation, Teresa is in complete tears, right? I mean, she's broken down. Bryant, the fact that you took the old school approach, not that you had to, the fact that you asked permission to marry Kayla, it meant a lot. It speaks volumes about who you are, your character, also how you were raised. John and Lisa, kudos. You raised a gentleman, and we were thoroughly impressed and blown away by the gesture. Ryan, you're an incredible guy, caring, loving, thoughtful, but you also have this magnetic personality and the ability to fill a room with energy. We're blessed to have you in our lives. We couldn't be happier to welcome you into our family. Here's to you. All right, I'm almost done.
I need to get the drinks.
Trace, get the drinks. And I'm old, too. I can't remember everything, so I actually have to have a cheat sheet. But that'd be good. I'd be like Rain Man. We should all go down to Reno and gamble if I could do this without notes. So Trace and I were sitting over the last couple of weeks. BK, you got a question? Oh. And not that we're the two most wise human beings on the planet, far from it, but a few words of inspiration and wisdom, which I think is always appropriate to share at an event like this. And this is stuff that's really worked for us. We would offer Kayla, you and Bryant, four things. Enjoy the journey. There are going to be ups and downs, highs and lows, twists and turns. It's all part of the adventure. Just embrace it. It's a partnership. Give and take. No right or wrong views, and be assured it will always evolve over time, just like any great partnership. Speaking from the two of us, 35, 38 years, counting pre-marriage. Just celebrated 35. Shocking that you've tolerated me that long. But,
stop.
Stay best friends. And Teresa always says, be playmates and constantly find things that allow you to spend time together. That's really important. Last but not least, we say keep chasing. Chase the dream. Chase the next adventure. Chase the next opportunity. Chase the future. Don't ever let up. Okay, I'm going to wrap this up. Mm-hmm. We couldn't be happier. I think everybody here knows we have a very small family. Our family just got bigger. Bryant, John and Lisa, Jen and Devin, your entire family. This entire group of extended family and friends, we feel incredibly fortunate to have you now part of our lives. Join me, raise a glass, to Kayla and Bryant, to love, health, happiness, and all that the future holds. We love you guys. Cheers.
Cheers.
Well, I think that's going to be a pretty hard one to follow up. Just want to thank everyone for being here. I think it means the world. I think Kayla and Bryant are obviously a lovely couple, as we all know, right? I mean, look at them. It's like something out of a Vogue magazine, right? Oh, Kayla, my sister, the girl I looked up to my whole life. Here you are, getting married. Unbelievable. But you found a great person. Bryant, love you too. And Kayla, I do want to clear up a quick thing on the head of Entourage game. I was supposed to have a turn after mine ended, but I'm still waiting for it. So, I mean, maybe when I'm old and in diapers or something, in a wheelchair, you can come help out, right? But no, I think, I don't know where I'd be in the world without Kayla. I think when I was in seventh grade, I had to write a paper on who's the most influential person in my life, and she was the first person to come to mind. And I've just always chased her around from the time I was a seven-year-old Grom, wanting to be as good as her on a snowboard, to learning how to windsurf together, to eventually her getting mad at me for getting better than her. The sibling rivalry definitely played a huge part in our lives. And just want to say cheers to that. Love you. And Kayla, I mean, I think you were kind of found an ace in the hole with B-Man over here. And let's go! True indeed. And for those of you who don't know, when we were in Palm Springs about to celebrate Kayla and Bryant's engagement dinner, Bryant took me golfing as a late birthday present. And I think it was on hole 16, right? I watched his ball trickle into the hole. And if that's not an incredible symbol of luck and a blessed relationship with these two, I don't know what is. So let's raise a glass to that. Bryant. Hole in one. It went in the hole. It did. Yeah, I mean, just want to say, the two of you, Bryant always wanted a brother, now I got one, and Devin, and Jen, another sister in the family. Love you guys so much. Thanks to everyone for being here. John, Lisa, Teresa, DJ, all you guys, everyone, awesome time. And cheers to love, happiness, and let's have a hell of a night.
Thank you both, oh my gosh, I'm already messing. I want to thank both families, both the Kohlers and the Jensens, for throwing this amazing wedding for two beautiful people. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Jules. I met Kayla in college when we were taking a course in South Africa. My first introduction to Kayla, we were paired as roommates, not knowing each other. She seemed nice enough, a put-together kind of gal. But as I was unpacking, I heard a subtle noise outside our room. Then I heard Kayla respond, "Hello?" If you know Kayla, you know the hello. I heard the subtle noise again for the second time. Kayla again, "Hello?" On the third response, I realized Kayla was talking to a bird. Sweetness in Kayla had no idea. I thought to myself, great, I'm paired to the girl who talks to birds for the rest of this trip. This should be really interesting. And interesting it was, because I built a strong friendship to the girl that talks to birds. And as fate had it, we spent the following year living across the street from another in San Diego, and that's where our friendship truly blossomed. For those of you that met Kayla, you know how compassionate, kind, caring person she truly is. She truly has a heart of gold. Kayla, you're ambitious, a go-getter, and a force to be reckoned. You are an amazing friend, and I know I don't tell you that enough. Not only are you an incredible friend to me and the many people here tonight, but you are going to be an incredible wife to Bryant. Bryant, I'll be nice. You always befriend people with open arms. You know the perfect way to calm our little worrywart. Your energy is vibrant, free-spirited, and a true Peter Pan. My first night out in Portland, I was with you. I was so confused. I felt like I was hanging out with a celebrity with everyone coming up to you. I was like, Kayla, who is this guy? I can instantly see how he stole Kayla's heart with his desire to have a good time and live in the moment. He sees the true value in people, and he always puts Kayla and her feelings before his own. You are a true gentleman. Kayla and Bryant, you both possess so many amazing qualities that have brought us here together. Your unconditional love for one another, your passion, your open hearts to those around you. Your love and sense of humor is infectious, which seems to be the trend of the word tonight. So there comes a point in this speech where I'm supposed to give marriage advice, but I've only been married for 4 years. So here's what I have found in my marriage that seems to be successful. One, I'll do the dishes. My husband needs to work on that one. Two, you are right. I need to work on that one. And most important is I'm here for you. Now, Kayla, I'd like you to put your hand on the table. Bryant, I would now like you to put your hand on Kayla's hand. I want you to remember this special moment, Bryant, because this will be the last time you ever have the upper hand in your relationship.
Hello, everybody. This is Lisa, my lovely bride. 48 years of a relationship, 38 years married. We're very proud, yeah. Boy. So I promised not to deliver death by PowerPoint. Thank you. There you go, Kate. Some of you heard a story or two a few nights ago, but I do have a story I'd like to tell. But the first thing I want to say is let's please give it up for the Jensen family for an incredible... Thank you, DJ and Teresa. Unbelievable. This is just so special. You know, our friends, Mary and Barney Davidge, Mary once said, your family isn't just the people who share your name or a bloodline. Your family is who you choose to spend time with. And as I look around this group, Kayla, your friends, Bryant, your friends, this is a family that we've known maybe since grade school, maybe since high school, maybe since college, maybe since Adidas or Nike or others, now Conscious Minds for Bryant. Kayla's got some new friends from Kombucha or other businesses she's been in, and just an incredible group of people who love each other. So it's the love that Bryant and Kayla shared today, just down during the wedding ceremony, which was so bright, is also shared by everybody in this area, and it's just fantastic. So we have been joyful to be part of this group of young people that we hold so special and so dear. So thank you all for making the effort to be here. We love you. You're our family. This is the family that our Jensen and Kohler family are part of, and we love it. Now, maybe one story, a cruel story perhaps. So maybe one story is a story about Bryant and Jennifer growing up. And I really kind of devised this when Bryant was about 12 years old, and Jennifer had to go through it, but her leap wasn't quite as large as Bryant's. And the big room in our house was always the room for homework, the room for a serious conversation, time out, or something else, but it was this large living room. And so I brought Bryant, when he was about 12 years old, into the living room, and he was like, uh-oh, what's going to go on here, right? I could tell. He was like, oh, well, what do you mean, Dad? What are we doing here? And we sat down. I said, Bryant, you know, I've been your parent. I'm your dad, but I'm also your parent. And parents tell you, when you shake someone's hand, you look them in the eye, clean your room, don't tell a lie, get your homework done. If we're back from a trip, help us unpack the car, for Pete's sakes. You know, is there anything I haven't told you as your parent, you know, or mom? You know, is there something that we've missed? Can you think of anything? And he's like thinking through, no, Dad, we kind of went through some other, no, Dad, I can't think of anything that you haven't told me. And so I said, you know, what I want to do is I want to shift our relationship from being your parent to being your dad. Yes, I'm your father. Yes, I'm your parent, but I'd rather be your dad. Someone who is a counsel, someone who you can goof off with, someone who you can come to for advice without recrimination or being a parent or punishment or any of those sorts of things, or, you know, and so I want to do that. Do you like that better? Yeah, I'd like that better, Dad. This is cool, right? So he's like still in shock, I think. And so we kind of go through a few more of those iterations. We concluded with, so Bryant, I promise to faithfully discharge my duty as a parent. And Mom promises to faithfully discharge her duty as a parent. But not quite as early. Okay, yeah, but... All right, maybe I was ahead. She's still, but you know, this is the promise I was making to our son. Yeah. So, but only if you only need to be reminded of something that we already know. We've already told you. You already know it. So, if we have to be a parent, please don't put us in that role. Just do the right thing. Yeah, Dad. Okay, I get it. And the cruel part of that was, any time that he did leave his room messy, didn't help us after we got home from a trip to unpack the car. Somebody said, Bryant, you know, I have to be your parent again. Why are you doing this? Right? Oh, shoot. Right? So it kind of changed the dynamic, which was kind of cruel, especially for a 12-year-old. Well, now we're at the wedding day. There's a couple things I want to add to the list. Love your wife unconditionally. Communicate. Never stop communicating. Even when it's hard, always be there, communicate. No walking out of the room or anything else. Definitely offer to do the dishes. So, nice one, Jules. That's good. I think maybe the most important is to surround your household with love. And inside will be the bright lines of your own parent, we hope, someday. But surround all of that with love. And to that, we wish you, and I don't have a glass. Anybody want to help me here? All right. Thanks, Katie. Sorry for the lack of glass. So we wish you a world of joy, a world of adventure, a lifetime of love, and this loving, proud family with you the whole way. May you all be with each other. Hear, hear.
Sup? I'm Ben. And believe it or not, that is the exact same way that I introduced myself, not only to Bryant, but also to his mother and father, within the very first hour of Bryant's very first day setting foot on campus at the University of Oregon. Let's go, Ducks. Now, unlike Bryant on that day, who was dressed like he was straight out of a Nautica catalog, I, on the other hand, was dressed like I was set to make an appearance on the next great white rapper show. And so I can only imagine that in that moment, John and Lisa were thinking a couple of things. Number one, who the hell is this guy? And number two, how do I ensure that he does not become friends with my son? And so I would definitely wager that if we were to go back in time, and I was to tell them, not only is that guy going to become friends with your son, but he's also going to have a microphone at his wedding. They probably would have packed up all his stuff, called whatever school was next on his backup list, and enrolled him there immediately. But nevertheless, here we are. I'd say we're doing okay. Now, what has transpired since that day has been a 17 to 18 year friendship, where I would say that Bryant and I have largely helped, but just as often inhibited each other from maturing into the two men that you see in front of you here today. And so as you might expect, I have quite the treasure trove of stories about this guy, given the timing and duration of our friendship. So when I was initially thinking about which of these stories I wanted to share while I was up here with all of you, I was kind of overwhelmed. But then I got to thinking about it, and I figured, well, if everybody here knows Bryant, and you all clearly know Bryant, then you've probably also come to appreciate the penchant that Bryant has for telling the same stories over and over in somehow increasingly greater and greater detail every single time you hear them. And so rather than risk doing the same thing to everybody here and telling you a story for the fifth, sixth, seventh time you've heard it, I figured we could just reserve some of those for the bar later tonight, and I'm going to jump right to the point when Bryant first told me about Kayla. So I remember we were sitting there at a bar, having a beer, catching up, and Bryant turns to me and goes, So I've been hanging out with this new gal. I go, cool, man. I love it. Tell me about her. Well, you know, she's 23. Nice. But in all seriousness, you dating a younger gal, that wasn't anything that surprising. What else? Well, you know, I met her at work. Okay. It's not the smartest thing you've ever done, but Nike's a big place. Sure, there's a number of degrees of separation. Probably can't get yourself into too much trouble, right? Well, yeah, about that. You know, she's got a desk that's pretty close to mine. She's actually on my team. Now look, Bryant is a very sharp guy. But for being as sharp as he is, he can do some really dumb shit sometimes. And so just for perspective, Bryant and I graduated in 2009 at the height of the Great Recession. Like, jobs were few and far between, and jobs in our desired areas of interest were even more rare. And so I remember for 3 to 4 months after school, not only Bryant, but also Austin was sleeping on the floor of my tiny one-bedroom apartment in Lake Oswego. And the only reason I could afford it was because I had an internship, not even a job. I say this because we had to scratch and claw to get to where we were at that point. So here's Bryant telling me about how he's dating this, this 22-year-old coworker who's also on his team, and I am fully expecting that the next thing that's going to come out of his mouth is that he's our boss. And so I'm having flashbacks to him sleeping on the floor of that one-bedroom apartment because he's about to be right back in that same spot on my own floor when his ass gets fired from Nike for hooking up with his subordinate. Now, thankfully, that wasn't the case. But that was the context that I had going into meeting KJ. But then I met her. And I'm not going to say I knew. But I will say that I had, within the first 5 minutes of meeting her, a very strong hunch that we were going to wind up here one day with the two of them getting married. And the reason for that, I don't know if it was Kayla's mannerisms or the way that she carried herself, she reminded me just ever so slightly of another important lady in Bryant's life, and that was his mother, Lisa. Now, it's not always the case, but I've generally felt that guys tend to wind up marrying gals who resemble or have certain characteristics or traits in common with their mothers. It was for me. I know it was for a few of the other boys up here, too. And so when I recognized this, the alarm bell started going off. I was like, what is going on here? So I had my hunch, but I kept it to myself. And they're looking at me. I don't even think they've ever heard this story. But the reason that I kept my hunch to myself was I didn't want to put any more pressure on their relationship. When they started, they had a lot of scrutiny on them, whether it was the work thing, the age difference, the sheer fact that it was Bryant Kohler, who hadn't had a long-term relationship in nearly a decade. Are Peter Pan among the Lost Boys? Can I get a true indeed? But underlying my desire to not put pressure on their relationship was the fact that really, I really liked KJ. From the get-go, everybody's talked about it. I don't know how you could not love KJ from the start. She has this, please. She has this warm, positive, fun energy that just radiates from her. And so I wanted to see whatever this blossoming relationship was work. Anyway, long story short, turns out my hunch was right, and the rest was history. So since that day, I've had the absolute pleasure of getting to watch their relationship unfold. And for those who don't know, I'm an only child, but I can imagine if I had a brother, I would love him the exact same way that I love BK. And honestly, bud, while I would like to say that I am most happy for you that you met KJ, I'm selfishly more happy for me. And the reason for that is because it means not only do I get to spend all of the many years to come with you, but also with this wonderful gal who I've since grown to love like a sister. You are the turkeys, our players, and I look forward to watching you settle down, raise your kids, start a family, and all the other joys that come along with this journey. And know that no matter what happens on that journey, through the ups and downs, I will promise you that Jill and I will always be there right by your side. I love you both so much, and I wish you nothing but joy and happiness in the years to come. So with that, and for John and Lisa's sake, get my ass off this microphone, and let's give a cheers to the Kohlers.
Hello, everyone. Damn. This is something else. Oh, thank you, Devin. Everyone told us that it would go by like a flash, which it is. And everyone said that we should find a moment to take these mental pictures. I've been trying to do it all day. I know Kayla has as well. I took a lot when we were on the altar together crying. They're a lot of the same crying, you know. But just want to say the one thing that sort of hit me and hit both of us is that all these people that we love from across the country, across the world, from all walks of life, all phases of life, have come here in the middle of the forest in the Sierra Nevadas to celebrate us and to, yeah, just to cheers us. And I think that means that's what's hit us the hardest. So I want to thank you all so much. I want to thank the Jensens big time. Cheers to them. Want to thank my parents as well. Thank you so much. Particularly want to thank a big special shout out to Teresa, wherever she's at. Teresa, we wouldn't be here. Look at this place. This is not possible without you. So thank you so much. You want to say anything?
That's it.
No. yeah, it's just been a special, special time for all of us, for Kayla and I. So, and now, what we made sure there was a lot of time for, was making use of this dance floor. So, so I hope that all of you guys are ready to party, ready to have fun. What? Yeah. Oh, yeah. The tarps are coming off tonight. So be ready. Be ready for it.
First dances.
What? Oh, yeah. Yeah. We're gonna do some dances first, and then you will feel the energy. Let's do it. All right. Thank you guys so much. Love you all.
First steps, first words, seems like yesterday you were just a girl. Skin knees, climbing trees, all those memories so close to me. Now you're a woman. All in love and nearly gone, but you'll always be my baby. No matter where you are, you'll always be my baby. Forever in my heart.
Here comes song number two. Round of applause for Kayla and her pop. Now, Bryant and his mom. Little Kenny Loggins for us all.
Christopher Robin and I walked along under branches lit up by the moon, posing our questions to our Dior as our days disappear all too soon. But I've wandered much further today than I should, and I can't seem to find my way back to the wood. So help me if you can, I've got to get back to the house in Brooklyn by one. You'd be surprised, there's so much to be done. Count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds from the sky.
Chase the clouds away.
Back to the days of Christopher Robin.
Came to
So I set him to ask of the owl if he's there, how to loosen a jar from the nose of a bear. Help me if you can, I've got to get back to the house, who called by one. You'd be surprised, there's so much to be done. Count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds from the sky.
Applause for Bryant and his mom. That was so adorable. Thank you. All right. So, lest I'm mistaken.